Geico asks, how would you love a chance to save some money on insurance? Of course you would. And when it comes to great rates on insurance, Geico can help. Like with insurance for your car, truck, motorcycle, boat, and RV. Even help with homeowners or renters coverage. Plus, add an easy-to-use mobile app, available 24-hour roadside assistance, and more, and Geico is an easy choice. Switch today and see all the ways you could save. It's easy. Simply go to geico.com or contact your local agent today.
Take the next step toward the career you want, be it business, cybersecurity, healthcare, or more. UMGC can help you get there. No application fee when you apply by August 31st. Visit umgc.edu, certified to operate by Chev.
What's up? It's your boy, the Ted Smith. Thanks for listening to the Men's Room Daily Podcast. Want more? Check out the greatest podcast in all the land, The Podcast. Be sure to subscribe and listen to a brand new episode every Tuesday night.
The shenanigans continue. This is the Men's Room with Miles and Thrill. 99.9 KISW.
Your guess is good as mine. Coming up, our category is the snobbiest states in the United States of America and your favorite cereals. But first time for a few emails from the Men's Room at KISW.com.
You've got mail. You've got mail.
First one here, dealing with a rabbit. We have the story on random question there about a roommate that decided to, well, eat his ex-roommate or current roommate's pet
current
rabbit.
Current roommate, and the rabbit's name was Pickles. Somehow that's important to the story.
Somehow, he did not get to eat the
He killed it and cooked it. He said his intent was to eat it, but he got arrested before he got the chance to enjoy his culinary expertise.
Which is amazing the police got there that fast. Like, the roommate must have realized what had gone on, then called the cops, and in that time he couldn't even have a bite of this?
I think the desperation you would... Because at that point you think perhaps my serial killer is... my roommate's a serial killer.
Mm-hmm.
That's not normal stuff like he put his toothbrush in my butt. Like,
yeah.
He killed and cooked my pet.
So this one says, growing up, guys, I always chose sweet and sour rabbit and rice for my birthday dinner. Not sure where my mom learned to make it. Her family was a bunch of hillbillies. Maybe they hunted bunnies. I don't know. Now I need to find me some rabbit. Thanks for the reminder. That from Jamie.
Bunny hunting.
As we move on to the birthdays, guys, Olavicholas, it's my birthday and Satan apparently showed up. Just got out of work and the shop was 115. Thank God for my car's AC. Let's get an inspirational quote from Miles and the Dirty Germans talking about how I should cool off tonight. Love you guys. That's from our buddy Josh. Okay, inspirational quote. All right, Josh. Remember to never be afraid to try something new. Remember that amateurs built the Ark. Professionals built the Titanic.
Yeah, you need to call off tonight. This is out of my realm of expertise, but I do know that German Ted has done things with ice cubes that might help.
Yes, you know, so you play some games, you say the ice cube and you sentence up the ice shoot.
I thought it was called the ice hole.
I thought you recommended that no one ever try that.
Well, yeah. Regular Ted thinks it's a bad idea.
But German...
Yeah. Yes, the Germans say so.
Yeah, we call them the ice cube trick.
The problem is, I just couldn't get the ice cube out, but I couldn't stop clenching.
What about the shape of the cube? Do you think that would make a difference?
Yeah, this was your standard, like, ice machine out of your fridge.
Oh, all right.
Oh,
that seems like
no.
the better.
I feel like if you had, like, the ice ball,
yeah,
be a little easier. Mm-hmm. I don't want anything with corners.
Was that your idea?
It was, like, you ever seen those things where you're, like, you roll the dice... And then you do whatever the dice say.
Yeah.
I don't remember how the ice cube got involved, but...
This was not Cranium you're playing.
No, it was not. But yes, that was one of my things.
This is a game that I didn't know
how to
play.
You know, you live and learn.
Right. Live and learn. Now you know.
Yeah.
Hey, guys, I want to give my husband, Troy, a birthday shout-out. Can we have the Dirty Germans talk about how he can celebrate in this heat? Thanks, guys, from Emily.
Yeah, tonight I will be your Trojan horse.
Yeah, maybe just take a cold shower and celebrate the birthday a different day.
Yeah, I have to be sweatier and stinkier than most times.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's so hot out today. I would say no to sex.
Yeah, no cuddling.
No, Jesus.
Just watch me do this.
Yeah.
I'll watch you do that.
Still say no to sex.
I would. I don't have air conditioning.
Yeah.
It would be a sweaty mess.
God, that would be hard to do.
I know, but man, like, I've had hot, sweaty sex, and, like, it was kind of great, but here's the problem. When you get to completion, it still feels great, but the only thing you're thinking about until you get there is, like, this is disgusting, and the sounds that it makes, man, because now you start getting, like,
get to fat
and that's just your bellies, man, you know what I mean? Like, it's not even the sounds of sex, it's just that wet, moist right, and like, body.
Your sweat, you would strip it off your nose. It's landing on them.
Yeah, you don't want them on top because then like they're dripping down your mouth. Like, damn, man, this is some nasty sex.
Okay, guys, here we go. Happy, happy, happy birthday. Happy, happy, happy birthday. Happy, happy, happy birthday to you, to you, to you.
Yaws of Dirty Germans brought to you by Men's Room Original Sausage. Available through Uli's World Famous Sausage, mensroomlive.com, and other fine retailers. Mmm, Schweinefleisch.
Thank you, Mom, and appreciate it. Let's get a contestant on the line for your guess is as good as mine now. 206-421-ROCK. First couple extra emails, what happened to my head?
And nasty stuff.
Guys, age 10, 27 years ago, there was a miniature golf course in front of a movie theater in Pierce County. It had an Orbitron in the middle of the course, surrounded by a fence that you could play on when you were done golfing. My mom was married to a military guy whose squad hung out on their downtime. Four of us got done golfing first, myself and three squad mates. One of them gets strapped in and the other two start spinning in as fast as they can. Little me must have felt powerful because I decided it'd be hilarious if the Orbitron dead stopped and got spun the opposite direction and proceed to grab the outer bar ring. It pulls me in, I giggle on the way up, then the other two bars smash into my head. The Orbitron stopped dead. I ragdoll into the fence. I screamed at some point, at which my mom was taking a swing. She flung her club and hit another of the squad in the head. No fractures or anything, very large lumps on my head. I'm currently writing a book about body pain because of it. Cheers, guys.
Oh, inspired you to be an author.
Guys, my grandson turned 15 on the weekend, so we couldn't do a shout-out. When he was 10, his little brother brained him with a fist-sized piece of granite. They lived in the boonies in eastern Washington and took an hour to get to the hospital. The doc stapled his head back together, then sent him home. Middle of the night, he's crying from pain and can't sleep. His wound is so swollen, the staples are actually popping out. They called the ER and sent paramedics immediately. He got his first helicopter ride to Spokane. They said he was lucky to be alive. No sports of any kind anymore. His skull was cracked and pieces of the rock and dirt were still in it. A lawsuit is still pending. He was pretty bummed. My daughter told him that something bad has to happen for your superpowers to be revealed. That from Grandpa Bernie. And one more. This is about a penis injury. Guys, we were on our way to a dirt bike event and had stopped someplace for the night that had bathrooms and some amenities. The bathrooms were a ways away from where we were staying that night, so taking a bicycle to the bathroom, that was pretty common. Now, my Uncle John, not to be confused with someone's fat uncle, had to go and took his bike over this little grassy hill. The hill created a bit of an optical illusion where it met the edge of the parking lot. Well, Uncle John, he did not see the approximately 3-foot drop. This would normally be no big deal. We're dirt bike people. We're used to this. Well, there was just enough space between the drop-off and the parking curb to perfectly wedge that bicycle tire. Uncle John hits his penis right on the clamp for the handlebars. He screams and runs into the bathroom. When he comes back out, he goes from trailer to trailer, showing everyone in his group his penis. It split.
Mm.
The top of the urethra split about a half inch, maybe smaller up to the helmet. They had to give him medication to help inhibit him from getting excited so that it would not split more. Pictures included of the hill, not of my uncle's penis. Peace out, bitches. Appreciate it.
Well, that's good.
Mm-hmm. All right, now time for a little Your Guess is as good as mine. It's an easy game to play. We get a contestant on the line. You pick from one of two categories and try to get as many right in said category before three strikes and you're out. Steve, who is our contestant? Way to play Your Guess is as good as mine.
Oh, you know. He's almost human. He enjoys cold gin. But we just call him Joe Dredd. Hello, Joe Dredd. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola.
Hola.
Joe, welcome to the program. Your guess is as good as mine. Okay, Joe, your categories. We have America's top 10 favorite breakfast cereals. You like cereal?
Yep.
These are not necessarily the healthiest of cereals, so
no, because people like them.
That's what I would think, yeah.
They're not going to be on your top shelf, but they are the favorite cereals that people enjoy eating.
Right.
Then someone ranked the snobbiest states in America. They looked at graduation rates, how many people got their degrees in the arts, how many top-tier universities there are in general, and how much wine people drink. And we have the top 10 then, quote, snobbiest states in the United States. So, right. Joe, is it going to be cereal or snobby for you?
Well, you know, the last time I played this, the top 10 snobbiest states was a category. And, of course, I didn't pick it because that's why it's there again. And that's why I'm like, you know what? I'm going to try again. And I'm going with breakfast cereal.
Breakfast cereal it is. We try to bring the categories around every once in a while, but didn't mean to double you up. But anyway.
Well, no, it took a long time for somebody to finally go the top 10 rock bassist, and I really tried to call in on that one.
Yeah.
Well, of course you did. Yeah.
And I'm glad I didn't, because I wouldn't have won.
Yeah, see, here's the difference. You and I play bass, so no matter what we think, we're wrong. That's a guarantee.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you guys are going to have a much different opinion.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
Because we know it's me and Joe Dre. Okay. I mean, like, those are your top two.
I was going to say, with the heat out there, maybe cold cereal for dinner is not a bad idea.
It's not.
I'm not a bit above it.
Oh, man.
Get on it.
I was at the deli this morning looking for breakfast. They had tomato and watermelon salad. It was all cut up, and I looked at that, and I was like, man, that looks cold and delicious.
It looks cold.
It looks so good, though.
I dominated some watermelon yesterday.
Yeah. Yeah, it was good. All right, Joe, these are not the healthiest cereals. These are your average Joe's favorite cereals on Your Guess Is As Good As Mine. So let's get it going here. These are the top 10 favorite breakfast cereals in the United States. What is your first guess?
All right, well, let's go with Thrill's favorite, Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Number one.
Oh, yeah.
Believe it or not.
Booyah.
That is America's favorite cereal.
I can believe that. It's freaking delicious, man.
Well, think about it this way, too. As much as Steve talks about Cinnamon Toast Crunch, we have a number of listeners that send in anything that is flavored with Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Oh, yeah.
And if you look at the world of cereals, it is clear that Cinnamon Toast Crunch dominates based on all the other products they have.
Ice cream, coffee creamer.
The taste of the cereal. So no other cereal markets itself quite like that, right? I mean, it's fair to say. Right.
Thank you for listening to me, world. Yes.
Okay. Joe, you're one for one. Cinnamon Toast Crunch is number one.
All right, well, I'm going to go with my childhood favorite. It's an old school favorite. Kellogg's Frosted Flakes, Tony the Tiger.
Ooh, all right.
Number three is Tony.
Ah!
He's a kinky tiger. He is number three.
He's not kinky. He's racist.
No, I learned that last week.
Red bandana to hide the swastika.
Yeah, exactly.
It's a contractual obligation.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you're two for two.
Okay, so those are the only two that were at the top of my list. I'm going to throw it out here. Which do you guys think would be better, Fruity Pebbles or Cocoa Pebbles?
Man, I feel like Fruity Pebbles sells better. My opinion is the exact opposite, but I think Fruity Pebbles sells better.
Well, let's go with Fruity Pebbles.
Number six.
Really?
Okay.
Fruity Pebbles is number six on the list. That is correct. Yeah.
Okay.
All right, you're three for three. Not bad, Joe.
Stay on the chocolate list and go with Count Chocula.
Count Chocula. No, not one of America's favorite cereals.
By He's a legend.
Way, blood isn't the only thing that Count will suck.
Mm-hmm. Joe, do yourself a favor. Forget about chocolate. Chocolate does not show up in the top 10 breakfast cereals. It just doesn't. Because I thought it was going to be kind of predominant. It's just not there.
Okay, what was that? Frosted Mini Wheats.
One of my favorites, number 10.
That made the list, all right.
Yes, it did. I mean, that is an old man cereal, but they do it in a way with a frosting on the side that makes me enjoy it very much.
Yeah, yeah, the frosting is methamphetamine.
Man, I would think maybe Honey Nut Cheerios or Raisin Bran.
I was going there next, Ted. There we go. You're on point there.
Which one?
Honey Nut Cheerios.
Number 8.
Yeah, I love those.
Okay.
Oddly enough, Buzzy the Bee has a nut allergy. Can't eat the stuff.
5 out of 10, Joe. Halfway to home. One strike against you.
Five, it gives some anal leakage.
I'm drawing a blank. I need some help, guys.
What about, like, Lucky Charms?
Captain Crunch.
Oh, yeah. Captain Crunch, actual cereal.
I didn't want to say anything.
Yeah, Captain Crunch.
Number 5. Yeah. Jesus Christ, man.
Thank you very much for that, everyone. I appreciate it.
Now, is Captain Crunch with Crunch Berries a totally separate thing?
I'm going to just tell you right now, there's no more of the Captain involved. It says Captain Crunch, but I'm assuming that that's
good. You know goddamn well it's with the Crunch Berries.
That means the original. So it does not mean Peanut Butter Crunch.
That's why I added those little pink balls. I got the idea of looking at myself in the mirror naked one day.
All right, well, we're going to go with Ted's guess and go with Lucky Charms.
Lucky Charms. Number 2!
Oh, wow!
I cannot believe that is a number 2 cereal, but
I can. It's Lucky the Leprechaun. He doesn't just love Lucky Charms. He also loves autoerotic asphyxiation.
Lucky does?
He sure does.
That is some kinky stuff. Who knew?
I have a whole room set up for him on the USS Guppy.
7 out of 10, Joe.
Calm down there.
7 out of 10. One strike against you. There are 3 cereals left. So far, you have correctly guessed Cinnamon Toast Crunch, Lucky Charms, Frosted Flakes, Cap'n Crunch, Fruity Pebbles, Honey Nut Cheerios, and Frosted Mini Wheats.
Okay, and then they're all sugar-based, right?
Again, these are the favorites.
There is one that I don't believe has enough sugar.
I'm going to play the numbers.
That would be Raisin Bran, then, wouldn't it?
You want to guess Raisin Bran?
I've got to guess Raisin Bran.
Raisin Bran's number 11.
Ooh.
It just skirted the outside of the top 10.
Okay. So the non-sugar one, I'm going to take another shot, and it's going to be my third strike if I miss it.
Right. Oh, this, you already got two.
That's what he's saying. It'll be the third.
Oh, yeah. It'll be the third. Sorry, I thought you said it'd be
the
first.
I'm going with Rice Krispies. I'm going all out for Rice Krispies.
God, that's a great guess, but no. People do not like it.
Well, before we let you go, Joe, when it comes to Rice Krispies, it used to be represented by Snap, Crackle, Pop, and Slurp. But then to get rid of Slurp, they had issues when he showed up in blackface.
Jesus Christ.
What's his name? Slurp?
Slurp.
Hey, Joe.
So there was a guy named Slurp.
Yes, there
and
was.
And Lucky the Leprechaun sent to
Autoerotic effect. Okay. Yes, he is.
So Joe Dredd got Frosted Mini Wheats correct at number 10. He got Honey Nut Cheerios correct at number 8. Fruity Pebbles at 6, Captain Crunch at 5, Frosted Flakes was number 3, Lucky Charms number 2, Cinnamon Toast Crunch was number 1. There are 3 cereals remaining. You guys want to give it a go?
All right, you said one of them's still kind of healthy, right?
It does not have as much sugar as I prefer.
I'm going to guess either just straight Corn Flakes or maybe just straight Cheerios.
What's your guess?
How about Cheerios?
Cheerios is number 9.
Yep.
Okay, 2 left.
You ever heard of a leather Cheerio?
Both of these cereals have notable mascots. That's all I'm going to say. These two remaining cereals have mascots that you know.
It's not like Honey Smacks, is it?
Is that the frog?
I think so.
He's also a crackhead.
Fruit Loops.
Fruit Loops is number 4 on the list.
Yep. Congratulations to my friend Toucan Sam, who incidentally introduced me to both nipple clamps and methamphetamine during a trip to Tijuana.
We've got one more. One more.
Big mascot.
We have brought this up no less than 4 separate times today. 3 separate times. We had an in-depth conversation about it. Just think mascots.
Cereal mascots. Snap, Crackle, Pop, Slurp.
Guys got it? Any guesses?
Not Toucan Sam.
Number 10 is Frosted Mini Wheats.
Are they for kids?
Yes. Number 9 is Cheerios. Adults too.
Is it Trix?
It is Trix with a rabbit. It's the rabbit at number 7.
Yes,
there you go.
Indeed.
How do you make the rabbit?
You don't want to know. He makes them so sweet. But he made a lot of money sexually dancing in the jungles of South America. That's how we met, because he used to turn tricks. And that's why he calls the cereal tricks. You're eating sex, children.
Top 10 favorite breakfast cereals go as follows. Number 10, Frosted Mini Wheats, followed by Cheerios at 9, Honey Nut Cheerios at 8. Tricks at 7, 6 is Fruity Pebbles, 5, Cap'n Crunch, everybody.
Yay!
4 is Fruit Loops, 3 Frosted Flakes, Lucky Charms.
Hooray me!
And your number 1 favorite breakfast cereal, that would be Cinnamon Toast Crunch. You are listening to The Men's Room.
GEICO asks, how would you love a chance to save some money on insurance? Of course you would. And when it comes to great rates on insurance, GEICO can help. Like with insurance for your car, truck, motorcycle, boat, and RV. Even help with homeowners or renters coverage. Plus, add an easy-to-use mobile app, available 24-hour roadside assistance, and more, and GEICO is an easy choice. Switch today and see all the ways you could save. It's easy. Simply go to GEICO.com or contact your local agent today.
The best defense is a good offense. So before the sewer backs up into your home and wreaks havoc, stop freaking and call Beacon. Beacon Plumbing, Heating, and Mechanical is there for you when you need them most. 1-800-FREAKIN or beaconplumbing.net.
Take the next step toward the career you want, be it business, cybersecurity, healthcare, or more. UMGC can help you get there. No application fee when you apply by August 31st. Visit umgc.edu, certified to operate by Chev.
KISW, the men's room is in progress.
Coming up in just minutes, we will drink, we will toast for the shot of the day. And we do have your headlines on the way 1 hour from now. But first, quick check-in with Mike Hawk and some of the stories and headlines he is not working on.
He's angry. A man in Oklahoma found his cat stuck in a tree and went up to help him out, and then got stuck up there himself and had to be rescued.
Thanks for your help.
Right. Now do you see why I'm up here?
Now I just have company.
No, I'll just wait for you to come down, buddy.
Exactly.
You got up there, you got claws, you can get your ass down.
You know how to do it. An event in Kansas City, Missouri called Waterfest was canceled. Do you know why?
No water?
No, quite the opposite. It flooded.
Oh.
Oh. Okay.
Well,
Waterfest was big.
What did they expect was going to happen?
Going off, man. A grocery store chain in Missouri broke a world record by cooking and serving 13,000 pancakes in about 7 hours, 16 minutes.
It's a lot of griddles.
Were they were going for that record, I assume.
I believe so, yeah. But it's a grocery store chain. One, I've never heard a grocery store serving pancakes, so I'm kind of, I'd love to figure this one out. But 13,000. Like, I want to see, on average, what does IHOP do on a daily? You know what I mean?
I don't know. Make them waffles. Maybe I'll care.
You got to go to that breakfast bar in the morning, Mike. They have it in the deli section. They got your sausage. They got your bacon.
Do they really?
They got your scrambled eggs.
They're just making breakfast back there?
Yeah.
I've never seen any grocery store do that.
Yeah, just get there before 9 o'clock, man.
Yeah, fair enough.
I'd say that's me now, but that's where I'm at, Mike.
I don't know that I've been in a grocery store before 9 a.m. and I don't know.
Not in a good mood.
Yeah.
Not in a good place. It's fine. It's just you and a bunch of old people. There's no kids to deal with.
Sure.
There's none of that crap. I mean, really, you kind of own the place with you and a bunch of seniors. So it's not
You're
bad.
Living the life, Miles. Not, I got to hand it to you, brother.
It's easy in and easy out.
No, that's badass.
You know what I mean? You don't have to wait too long.
I'd have met you there, but I went to the bar last night. Yeah. So, and I missed my supermarket breakfast.
I do it sometimes on Thursdays. And you can ask Mike. I always come in and go, Mike, you wouldn't believe it. Thursday night, that's the time to go. Nobody there.
Yeah.
Seriously. Quiet. Get whatever I need.
Air conditioning's on.
A family cheese business in Wisconsin broke its own record by making a single string cheese that's 3,832 feet long.
So what? They just kept cranking it out, never cut it?
Right? I don't even know how they make string cheese, so I don't know how this works, really, but...
But sometimes you ask yourself, did you break this record because that particular employee's an idiot? Like, Eddie, you gotta cut the goddamn.
Bro, look at this.
Oh, my bad.
Well, I also like the, idea of somebody having to use, like how are you gonna peel that all the way off?
One big wrapper.
You get one big old piece of string off of that thing. Yeah, yeah. But again, why do you stop? Unless it just happens to break at 3,832 feet. You know, why don't you just keep going? Break that thing out of the water.
Feet. Not inches, but feet.
Feet. Yeah, this thing is over a half a mile long.
Jesus.
Sounds appetizing.
That's right. Come eat a mile of string cheese.
You have diarrhea? This will solve it.
It's a mile of string cheese.
It's a mile of string cheese. Yes. Matt Hancock, who is basically the British Dr. Fauci, resigned after he was caught breaking social distancing by having an affair and making out with an aide. Oops.
God damn. I don't care.
COVID's worth it for you, baby.
Yeah. That tongue piercing.
And the fact of the matter is, he lost his job because of the restrictions in place, not because of his improprieties.
Right. Right.
I mean, that's fair. If I found someone effing the hell, I don't care.
I don't know.
Right. Why does that matter to me?
But you broke COVID protocol.
Exactly.
Right, and he's the guy telling everybody to be careful.
Right. You're kind of the last person to do that.
Do
I think you should lose your job. I mean, if somebody cheats on their wife, I would say...
That's your business, man.
I'll put a condom on my tongue, sir.
Nope. Apparently, we already covered that one. Sales of Viagra going through the roof during the pandemic, which is just interesting.
Well, maybe that's also because everybody was gaining weight.
That's what he's saying.
Like, maybe people were having trouble staying at attention. So it's like, all right, let's...
You got fat and ugly.
Whiskey's a lot easier when you don't got to go to work the next day.
Right?
good news. Taco Bell's bringing back its triple-double Crunchwrap.
The triple-double. What does that entail?
So basically, it's another level of the Crunchwrap Supreme. This is my favorite thing that I get from Taco Bell, the Crunchwrap Supreme. Basically, it starts out with this with a regular soft shell. They put the ground beef and the cheese on the bottom. They put a hard shell disc, basically, on all top of it. And then they give you the lettuce and the tomato, the sour cream, and the rest of the cheese and all that. They fold it up. What they do with this triple-double is they add another stack of beef with it. Yeah.
More beef.
Yeah. So they released it a little while back. They called it the Triple Double. Then they got rid of it. But now it's coming back under the name the Grande Crunch. Means it's going to be here forever.
I think the reason they called it the Triple Double is because this will make you poop at least three times.
Right. You're going
to do three number twos as a result of this one meal.
I got to take a look at this.
I will say, people normally, you know, you
holy cow.
Oh, yeah. This thing's delicious. It's great. I love the Crunchwrap Supreme, and making a double is just fantastic.
That's like a torta, basically.
You know, you hear about people that they'll go to Taco Bell, and they'll get a full bag full of stuff. Man, this is all you need.
That looks good. It's That'd fantastic. Be my go-to, no mm-hmm. doubt.
It is great, man.
Somehow, yeah, Taco Bell, that's one of the few places where when I get something from there, which is rare, but I don't pull off the lettuce and tomato. Anything else I get, dude. You got lettuce and tomato. No big deal. I just pull it off. Taco Bell, I'm like,
we finally found out where it adds good flavor.
Taco Bell.
Is it because it finally adds flavor, or are you just so inebriated you just don't even care about it anymore until you don't want to pull it off?
Probably all of the above.
Okay.
I'm one of those weird people who eat Taco Bell sober.
Same. Love Taco Bell.
Love it for lunch.
What is that like?
Not me.
I will eat it sober, but it is probably simultaneously one of my favorite drunk restaurants to go to.
Yeah, no doubt.
Yeah, love it, man.
So many options.
Hell yes.
That and Jack in the Box.
Yes.
Oh, you can just order off. You can order like 10 appetizers there.
I remember when they had their fourth meal that came out. We all knew what that was for.
Yeah, yes, we did.
Here's a mac and cheese burger.
In all fairness, man, Jack in the Box and Taco Bell, they kind of pioneered that. We know you're stoned.
Right.
You know,
we know what's going on.
We're going to feed you stoner people.
Right. We're not here to judge. We're here to take your money.
We won't say the quiet part out loud. We're just going to billboard it and make money off
should
of it.
Should have said you get a meal deal for $4.20.
Aha, there you go.
Right. Just build it in.
Mm-hmm. They found the trick to getting kids to eat more vegetables. Put twice as many on their plate.
Why? Because they're going to try to get through as many as they can to make it look like they ate some? Is that it?
Or maybe they only end up eating half, so now they're eating a full serving? I don't...
Or maybe sounds to me you like, trick them into believing that it's something really delicious because you gave them so much? I don't know. Didn't work on my
sounds
ass.
To me like you're just wasting vegetables.
Right. Give your kids vegetables. Tell them to eat your vegetables. And then, you know, go about your day.
Yeah, well, you know, usually, with the exception of me, because I hate them all, but you realize which vegetables each kid likes.
Sure.
And that makes it a lot easier, man.
Right.
Son, nope. All about the green beans. Green beans, cucumbers, fresh green beans, of course.
Nice.
Cucumbers, they can both handle carrots. My daughter absolutely loves carrots. Give her carrots, make her a salad. She's good.
Cool.
My son doesn't want a salad. She doesn't want green beans. I don't care. But I know what you like. And she's now eating green onions raw, which is...
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'm just pulling straight out of the fridge. I'm like, okay, woodland creature.
Alrighty then.
Yeah, I'm with Miles. I feel like when I was a kid, we put cheese on everything.
Mm-hmm.
That's like the broccoli came with cheese on it.
Nice.
Yeah. You can eat this without it?
My family was just butter. Oh, man. Mothers upped their game in parenting in 2020, doing 173 extra hours throughout the year. 173 extra hours of parenting. Dads, however, 59.
And I'll tell you, they were delighted about that.
a lot of teaching involved, too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, man. A woman got a COVID test, and they found a tiddlywink that was stuck up there for 37 years.
How do you not know there's a tiddlywink in a nose? If I remember this right, they're about the size of a quarter.
Your guess
or maybe a dime.
Are those like, is that with like jacks?
It was a little flat disc, right? And you put one little flat disc, coin size, in your hand, kind of press the edge of a stationary disc to kind of make it jump.
Okay.
Look, man, we didn't have video games.
It's all good. So, I get it, man. It's
as
all
I'm
right.
saying this out loud, like, didn't we discover fire? But, yeah.
And then he shaved the corners off and made a wheel.
Let's stop this and play pickup sticks. Come on.
That's what I'm thinking of, right?
That's what Miles thought of this morning. Head, I'm like, right? No tiddlywinks, bro.
Oh, man.
It's the disc.
Our friends over at The Rab made a list of the 10 creepiest kids in horror movies. One thing we know to be a fact is that when kids show up in horror movies, I think they're scarier than any monster, ghost, creature, or whatever it is.
Always creepy.
The scariest ones out there. So, Mr. Hill, you're a little bit of a horror movie fan, if I'm not mistaken?
Horror movie,
horror
yes.
movie, yeah. So, who do you think would be on this list as far as creepy young children inside of these horror movies?
I know they're going to say people like Damien, but to me, he wasn't creepy. He's just an a-hole. But the two twins from The Shining.
Twins from The Shining.
There's no doubt. And the chick from The Ring.
Yes.
And obviously Linda Blair, because, you know, she spun her head around.
It depends on their version of kids.
How do you mean?
So, like, Sissy Spacek, right? Was she? No. Teenager.
She was Carrie, right.
She was Carrie, but she was a teenager.
Right. So, no, I think kids are single digits.
Malachi was like Children of the Corn, but he was a teenager.
He might be on there, though, bro.
Yeah, that's
people like that.
Ted, I'm not even going to ask you. You don't like horror movies.
I've seen movies with a lot of creepy people.
That's right.
Can I just name a random kid and be like, that one's creepy?
That one right there. No, for me, it was the kid from Pet Sematary.
Oh, when well,
he,
yeah.
When he grabbed that scalpel, man, goodness gracious. All right, so
I'm
here's our list.
I'm play with you.
It's not playtime.
Oh, man.
Come on, get the hell away from me.
10 creepiest kids in horror movies. Number 10, Charlie from Hereditary. It says, quote, the troubled teen trope with a sense of otherworldly dread, thousand-yard stares, and periodic tongue-clicking. I know that this was supposed to be some grand artistic horror movie, and I just suppose I don't get it. I didn't like the movie.
I did not see it. But a lot of times I take your word on it, and I think you may have been one who told me don't bother with it.
Right. Now, if you're somebody that reads into what the true horror of it all was, it's a movie for you. And it was groundbreaking for people that look into horror movies like that.
If you're looking for true horror, watch Fatal Attraction. I mean, like, look, man, like, there's true horror.
Right.
Like, just be creepy and weird.
Right. For me, a horror movie shouldn't cause more questions than it answers.
Exactly.
I shouldn't leave there wondering more about the movie. Number 9, Rhoda from The Bad Seed. I never saw this one, but it says, quote, an 8-year-old serial killer who hides her rage with a facade of pigtail precociousness. So,
okay. Well, the plot alone.
Sounds like she deserves to be there.
It sounds like another sort of Damien thing where she's the killer and everybody,
right,
but everybody else knows about it.
Except baboons.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Adrian from Rosemary's Baby, another classic that I need to see that I haven't yet. I know what the big twist is of it all, but
it's just real cerebral, dude.
It says, we never see the Rosemary's Baby, which makes the hold the devil spawn has on both its mother and viewers all the more impressive.
Yeah, they're right. I mean, kid basically shows up at the end, but you're like, yeah, this is after.
Well, there's the kid from Poltergeist.
Yes.
But she wasn't...
She wasn't creepy. She was...
creepy. She was just in a creepy situation.
Right. The fact that she was communicating with these...
Now, that makes you
with
creepy.
...with these poltergeists. Right. So that definitely has its own little
air.
Ted
just gave
there.
Me the look like, am I wrong?
No, she wasn't creepy. She was just talking to the poltergeist.
She was just talking to the ghost of the TV. It's all good.
My bad, Mike.
10 creepiest horror movies, creepiest kids in horror movies. Number 7, Isaac from the Children of the Corn series. The unofficial mayor leading the miniature citizens of the ritualistic slayings of adults is scarily charismatic in an overzealous King Joffrey-esque way.
See, I only got Malachi, but I guess he's not really a kid.
Right.
Again, I feel like they cast Children of the Corn. They said, that, you know, you put out an ad in Variety. Be honest with yourself. Does your kid look effed up and creepy?
Is your kid
Do people
scary
stare at your kid for no reason other than how creepy they look at the grocery store? We need him for this movie.
Number 6 of the 10 creepiest kids in horror movies, Mercy and Jonas from The Witch. Never saw that one. That's another one that was interesting.
I heard
about.
That's supposed to be really good.
What do you think all these movies would be good if the characters are this scary? Like, every one of these movies that you haven't seen, they all got to be pretty good.
Right?
Sure. These people wouldn't scare you. These kids wouldn't scare you.
Exactly. It says, quote, their playful taunting, even as older brother Caleb is at death's door, is downright chilling. So, wonder if they're just possessed by the witch's magic and all that. I'll have to do some research there. The 10 creepiest kids in horror movies. Number 5, Esther from Orphan. Did you guys ever see that one?
I did not see that movie.
Nope.
I'd heard good things about it.
I have a problem with Esther being put on there, but if I tell you what my problem is, I think it'll give away the spoiler of the movie. So it just says, quote, personally, I find no moment more disturbing than when she hits on Peter Sarsgaard. So the whole thing about Orphan is that they've brought in this young orphan girl, and she's just a little bit off. Mm-hmm. She just starts killing people. It's not okay.
She's not a little off.
Man, what does a kid have to be creepy for you to call him creepy?
I've seen a lot of horror movies, Ted. I've seen a lot of bad stuff happening. 10 creepiest kids in horror movies. Number 4, the Grady twins from The Shining.
Hell yeah. There you go, Steve.
Says maybe it's the girl's monotone delivery, maybe it's the shot's creepy composition. Either way, this is a classic horror scene for a reason. My problem...
It's their face.
It is their
and
face.
And you know who represents them now, except they actually exist?
Who's that?
And look at any picture of them and tell me I'm wrong. The goddamn Olsen twins.
Yes.
You tell me those two bug-eyed freaks are not... There's something wrong,
there's
man.
There's a reason why Elizabeth jumped the ship, man.
Yeah, these women are in their late 30s, 40s now. They have a media empire. Whatever it is they do, and still when I see pictures of them, I'm like, I bet you both of them are cold-blooded and sleep on the ceiling.
That's another one where I think that the twins in The Shining were ruined for me because they were referenced everywhere.
So by the time
they showed up, I already knew that they were going to happen. Now, it's still... I felt the impact when I watched the movie.
Yeah.
Number 3 of the 10 creepiest kids in horror movies, Samara from The Ring. Pure nightmare fuel with her long stringy hair, terrifying grimace, and fondness of creepy old Wells.
Yes. Yeah, she was creepy. And when my daughter was younger, and anyone who has a daughter has had this experience at least once, your kid is like 2.5 years old, but they're standing in the bedroom when you're asleep. You know what I mean? And you kind of wake up because you feel like someone's looking at you, and it's just the silhouette, and her hair's effed up. And I mean, you scream your ass off, you know, then they're crying like, "Oh, sorry, baby. I thought you were like a demon."
Number two, Reagan from The Exorcist. Says, although Linda Blair, who was only 14 at the time of the filming, certainly deserves her props, the unsung heroes behind this character are voice actor Mercedes McCambridge and makeup artist Dick Smith.
Without question, but they all brought it together to create this character. The people are scared.
And we're looking at her. So whoever else did the work, like, hey, you creepy little...
You can say what you want about Peter Mayhew, but it kind of was the guy who made the costume.
Right. It really sold Chewbacca. Really,
yeah, I mean, now you know he's Chewbacca.
And this is the number one creepiest kid in horror movies. You guys already know what we're going to say because it's already been said from the omen. It's Damien.
Damien!
Oh. It says Damien is quite literally the son of Satan. He acts in mysterious ways with much of the terror coming from the way in which people react to him.
By the way, someone chimes in and says, the girls from The Shining were not twins. They were 10 and 8 years old.
There's different
twins. Okay, the creepy sisters. Does that make them better?
They were dressed the same way. They looked the same way.
They were 2 years apart.
Goodness gracious. There's a wedding.
Boo.
There's a wedding RSVP that's going viral for a bit of a design flaw.
What was the design flaw,
Mike? Tell you all about it 1 hour from now.
Thank you. Well, the headlines are on the way 1 hour from now. In the meantime, let's get a contestant on the line for profile. This is 206-421-ROCK. All right, have we made it to drinking time?
Geico asks, how would you love a chance to save some money on insurance? Of course you would. And when it comes to great rates on insurance, Geico can help. Like with insurance for your car, truck, motorcycle, boat, and RV. Even help with homeowners or renters coverage. Plus, add an easy-to-use mobile app, available 24-hour roadside assistance, and more, and GEICO is an easy choice. Switch today and see all the ways you could save. It's easy. Simply go to GEICO.com or contact your local agent today.
For tank and tankless hot water heaters, for clogged drains, for leaky faucets, for toilets that won't flush, stop freaking and call Beacon. Beacon Plumbing Heating and Mechanical is your trusted source to solve all your plumbing needs. 1-800-FREAKIN or beaconplumbing.net.